because this was our last in-person class. I wish Donna might hop on 2 years ago. So we were 22 people in this room. And then the following week we were four. And then the world closed. Right? Everything that we knew just ended. So thank you for coming. So most of you know, we live in South Carolina now. We just kind of upped and left in August of 21. I don't know about you guys, but the past 2 years was not on my 5-year plan. Mm-hmm. It wasn't on my vision board. It wasn't anything that I could have imagined or envisioned. And there is our fifth yama is aparigraha, which is non-grasping. So the yamas are the spiritual practices that are the foundation of yoga. So there's eight limbs of yoga. They start with the yamas and the niyamas. We know asana practice, right? Because that's what became popular here. But there's so much more to it. And we can practice on our mat and use that as a vehicle so that we can develop these skills and then take them off of our mat and into the world. And that's a tough one, non-grasping. So what does that mean? We're driving here tonight and I was excited about the class. I put a lot into this, the planning. And as we're driving, my phone is pinging. Can't come, have to cancel, can't come. And now if I practice and live my yoga, it doesn't bother me, right? Because you're supposed to go out there, give it the best, and then release any expectation. So in real life, you get that little when it first happens. And then what do? Right? We breathe. We breathe. We relax where we can. And then we kind of repurpose it. Right? And I said, this is exactly who's supposed to be here tonight. If there were five more people here, the room might have been too crowded. We might not have been as comfortable. Right? And everything really shows up the way that it needs to. But we like to think we're in control. And sometimes we kind of try to force it. So there is a book called The Journey Home. I don't know if anybody's familiar with it. It's about a 19-year-old who went to India. He's an American Swami, like the only American Swami. He was drawn to India on a quest. And this is way before he prayed love. And he comes to the Ganges. And in India, that's the mother. Starts in the Himalayas and just kind of works his way to the sea. And he writes so beautifully about it. And I wish I had the quote with me, but I don't. Or do I? Yes, I do. Mother Ganges teaches us if we want to attain the sea of our aspiration, we must persevere in our goal and never be discouraged by the inevitable obstacles that come in our path. And the examples he gave, the mountains, the trees, the rocks, the boulders, regardless of what came into her path, she just made another way around, right? Went around, went over, went the other way. So tonight, I'm going to invite you to be that river, right? And we're going to start down on the backs. So I'm going to lower the lights a little bit so that they're not in your eyes. Just coming down onto the back and start focus on the breath. You might even want to bring the palms to the belly. Bend the knees if the lower back is a little tight, right? Make yourself comfortable here. We're just going to settle in and we're going to check in and see how we showed up tonight. Let's start to feel the breath as it moves through the body, the inhalation and the exhalation. And without changing anything, I just notice that breath. It's like a beautiful wave. Every inhale is bringing our prana, our life force, and every exhalation is a chance to let go. So imagine that the body is resting on a beautiful raft that's floating down a gentle river. See if you can start to relax the shoulders and the shoulder blades, the back of the head, the hips, and just let the body be supported, feeling the waves of breath as they wash over you. Relax the little corners of the eyes and the jaw. And then bring the breath deep into the belly, feeling the belly expand like a balloon. And as you exhale, exhaling completely, and just let your day roll off with that exhalation. Another deep breath into the belly, maybe even opening the mouth. And as you exhale, just sighing it out. And then setting an intention for tonight's class. So maybe something like, today I release my attachment to people, possessions, and thoughts that are blocking my way. I know when I let go, I welcome the natural flow of life. So using that ease, that fluidity, like a gentle river flowing. Bring that breath from the belly to the ribs all the way up to the collarbones. And then exhale completely as we spend a few moments in our three-part dirgha breath. So more important to be relaxed than worry about doing this wrong or right. Just filling the body with breath. And exhaling completely, squeezing the navel towards the spine. And we'll take three more like that. Deep breath into the belly. Feeling the expansion on that inhale. And as you exhale, let everything settle back down. And two more at your own breath cycle. And with that next exhalation, just release the dirgha. Go back to the natural breath. Notice how the body wants to breathe right now. And also notice if maybe something shifted a little bit. Let's bend the knees and bring them into the chest and give yourself a hug and a little rock and roll from side to side. And then step the left foot down on the mat. Keep the knee bent and extend the right leg out. Palms alongside the body, pressing into the mat, forearms pressing into the mat. Point the toes, and as we inhale, just sweep those right toes up to the sky. And as we exhale, flex the foot so we're pressing through the heel. And just let that foot float back down. Your choice, you can hover or let that heel touch the floor. And just coming in and out of these gentle stretches, inhaling on the way up, and as we exhale, flexing the foot and lowering down. Connecting the movement with the breath. I'll do one more on this side. And holding those right toes up towards the sky. As you exhale, just bend the right knee and cross the right leg over the left. Bring the arms outside like a T position from the shoulders, palms down, and start to gently rock the knees from side to side. So the left foot is still on the floor. And we're just taking that right knee like a little metronome going side to side. Notice the sensation in the lower back as we do this. And if this is too intense, you can uncross the legs and just put that other foot down on the mat. Let's come through center one more time. Inhale the right toes up. And as we exhale, just let that right foot come back down and bend the right knee and then extend the left leg out. Bring the palms back alongside the body for support. Inhale, sweep left toes up towards the sky. And as we exhale, flex the foot, push through the heel, lowering the foot down. And as we do this, try to embody that wave, right? That wave-like movement. Nothing is stiff, as if we're moving through water. The next time those left toes reach up to the sky, just bend the knee and cross that left leg over the right, and then take the arms out alongside the body and start that gentle rocking side to side with the left knee crossed over the right. And come back through center and uncross the legs and hug those knees into the chest one more time with a gentle rocking. And now your choice, either rolling to one side and pressing up, or you can gently rock on the spine a couple of times, coming into little spinal rocks and rock yourself up to seat. Whoo! Hi. So taking a comfortable seat that could be cross-legged. Legs can be out in front and sitting up nice and tall. Take the arms out alongside the body and start to sweep the fingertips out and all the way up towards the sky. As we exhale, float the fingertips down and let the chin drop down towards the chest. And we'll do this a few times. Inhale, coming up. Beautiful. And exhale, releasing down, letting the chin come down. One more time, sweeping the arms over your head. And then let the left hand find the floor and let that right arm come up and over, coming into a side bend, but keep pressing the right hip down. And then we'll just flow from side to side. Inhale brings us up, exhale takes us over. A little bend to that arm that has the palm on the floor. It gets you a little deeper into the side bend and try to keep the hips from popping up. The next time the left hand is on the floor, sweep the right arm up and over and start to make some big circles, right? Like we're churning up the water. Let's circle the other way. And then let the right fingertips reach all the way to the sky, bringing the body up through center. And as we exhale, take the right palm down, take the left fingers up towards the right and start the circles on the other side. Beautiful. I invite you to close your eyes if that feels comfortable here. Let's circle the other way. Bending the elbow to release the shoulders if they're tight. The next time those left fingers reach up, let it bring the body up through center and exhale, left hand floats back down. Inhale, both arms up towards the sky, let the palms meet. And as we exhale, take them down to the heart. Dropping the chin to the chest, breathing here. And just notice what's starting to happen in the body and the breath. And then opening the eyes. We're gonna bring the palms behind and separate the feet as wide as the mat or a little bit wider. And just kind of windshield wipe those knees side to side. We'll do a little bit of hip openers, some seated pigeon, and then we'll move into some standing postures. The next time the knees come over towards that right side, pause. Bring the right palm down and sweep the left fingers up. Now you can stay here just working this stretch or come on to that right shin, lifting the hips. Maybe take the left fingers behind you, opening up the heart, coming into our half circle or Ardha Mandalasana. As we exhale, let the hips come back down if they're up and take the knees up and over to the other side, extending right leg out. Left palm down, inhale, right fingers up. Staying here or rolling into the shin and lifting the hips. Maybe taking right hand behind, opening the heart towards the sky. And as we exhale, come on back down. We're gonna cross one leg in front of the other and take the fingers and interlace them behind the back. I'm just gonna turn to the side so you guys can see. Take the knuckles down towards the mat, shoulder blades down, lift the heart, drop the head back. And as you exhale, tuck the chin, let the head come down and lift the arms overhead, coming into seated yoga mudra. If it feels good, kind of tick-tock those hands from side to side, get a little release to the shoulders. And then use the next inhale to bring us back up, shoulder blades down and back, fingertips come to the mat. As we lift the heart and drop the head. And sweep the arms overhead, take a big breath in. And as we exhale, take a little forward fold, walking the fingers forward. No destination here, right? Maybe we're up nice and high. Maybe the fingers are on that block. Let the head drop with the hands. Just press into the mat, the left hand, then the right, just shifting from side to side. then walk the hands back towards the body and just come and roll over into tabletop. So if anybody needs any extra padding, there's more there was more mats down back there. There's more of these. Does anybody want me to open a window? It's really warm in here. Yes. Okay. I didn't know if it was just me. You let me know. You let me know if it gets too cold. Yeah, that's why I wasn't too sure about that. Is it me or not? Okay, a little bit of thread the needle. You might want to take a block with you, your choice. If anyone's knees are really cranky, you can always do this seated with a block just coming up and coming through. So that's your choice. Otherwise, pressing into the right hand. As we inhale, sweep the left fingers up to the sky. Take a breath here in our twist. And as we exhale, let those fingers come behind the right wrist, reaching all the way through. And then inhale, unwinding, lift fingers to the sky, beautiful. Exhale, coming through. And one more time like that, coming up. And then letting the shoulder come down, that temple maybe comes down to the mat, and we use the right hand to hold the body up as we reach the left fingers to the right. So this is our first part. If you're looking for a deeper stretch, the right arm can reach up to the sky. You can make little circles into the wrist, or even bend the elbow and take that hand to the lower back. We'll work into that bind where we're holding on to the left thigh and breathe. Remember, nothing ever hurts in yoga, especially around the joints. Take a big breath in. And if you took that bind, releasing, if the arm is up, as we exhale, press it back into the mat. And then unwind on the inhale, reaching left fingers up and let the left hand come back down. Let's take that to the other side. Press into palms, sweep right fingers up, big breath in. As we exhale, let that hand travel behind the wrist and through, dropping down. And unwinding on the inhale, coming up. And exhale, coming back through. Once more like that. And then let that right shoulder find the mat. Use the left hand if you need a little support, or take any of those options. Arms reach up, little circles into the left wrist, or the hands to the lower back. We'll find the bind. Big breath in. If you took that wrap, unwrapping, let that left hand find the mat. As we inhale, everything unwinds, reaching right fingers up. And then let the hand come back down. Okay, we're gonna get off of our knees. Tuck your toes and just start to lift the hips, coming into downward facing dog. And then bend one knee and straighten the opposite leg and take the side to side. If this doesn't work for the body tonight, you can come to the top of the mat and find a ragdoll pose. Otherwise, just walking out the dog, bending one knee, straightening the opposite leg, and then peek under the armpit of the straight leg, and then take that up and over to the other side. And then let's walk the feet towards the hands towards the feet, and meet in the middle of the mat. Bend the knees a lot, opposite hands to elbows, drop the head, and find ragdoll. Find this little swaying from side to side. Just breathing here. And then bring the palms to the thighs, and with a flat back, start to press the feet into the floor, lengthen up, bringing the body into stand. And then we take the shoulders up, down, and back. And sweep the arms all the way up and out. Let the hands meet in prayer, and exhale the hands to the heart. And just notice how it feels to be standing. I'm just going to shift my mat a tiny bit over. So for a standing sequence, you may want to have a block at the top of the mat. And remember that I'll give different options.
I know. Well, you know, it was like snowing yesterday.
And now today, I think it was 50. Okay, we're going to flow. Coming to the top of the mat. Feet are hip width apart. Put a little bend to the knees and straighten the legs. And do that a couple of times. Notice the engagement in the thighs. And then trying to straighten the legs, but resisting, right? This tiny little bend. We don't want to lock the knees. Take the tailbone, turn it down. Shoulders roll up, down, and back. Palms can face forward and get a little bit taller, lifting through the head. Relax the shoulders, relax the jaw. Beautiful. As we inhale, sweep the arms overhead. Take a big breath in. As we exhale, take that forward fold, and you can find your block or bend your knees as much as you need to. And then come to a half lift, palms to the shins or the knees, and we look up, make space, and exhale, come back down. Bend the knees as we press the floor away, sweeping the arms up, hands prayer, find a little baby back bend, and then exhale, hands to heart. So our sun breaths, we'll take more like that. Inhale, come up, exhale, forward fold. Find that half lift, lengthen, look up, and come on back down. Sweep the arms out as we press the floor away, rising all up, hands in prayer, and exhale, hands to heart. One more. Inhale, rising. Exhale, surrender, let it go. Find that half lift, lengthen, look up, and come on back down. Sweep the arms out as we rise. This time we're going to take hands to the hips and step the right foot back. So stepping the right foot back, coming on the ball of the foot, coming into a crescent lunge, unless that doesn't work for you, then you can drop the heel and find more of a warrior one pose. Not a big stance between the feet, but they're separated. Beautiful. I love the walls, right? So just make sure that knee doesn't cross the ankle. As we inhale, we're going to sweep the arms up and straighten that front leg. As we exhale, bend the elbows, bend the knee, and come into like a goddess arms, pressing the elbows back, spreading the fingers, beautiful, finding that space in the chest and the heart. Let's do that again. Inhale, coming up, straighten the leg. And as we exhale, coming back down. And one more time like that. Inhale up and exhale, releasing. And be okay with any kind of unsteadiness or shakiness. And we're going to straighten that front leg, bring the hands to the hips, and then take that back foot down, bring it a little bit closer. So now both heels are on the mat, and it's like we're on, you don't want to be like we're on railroad tracks, right? We don't want one foot in back of the other. And take the left hip, press it back, right hip forward. This is where you might want that block. Sweep the arms overhead. As we exhale, start to fold forward. First, bring the palms to the thighs. Press the hips back. Nice long spine. Notice the sensation down the back of that left leg. Might be enough, right? So if it is, stay here. If you're looking for a little bit more, maybe take that block. Bring the fingertips to the block. Maybe let the head release down. So breathe into the stretch going down the back of the leg. And notice the sensations, right? Notice the breath. Can you just allow whatever is happening in the body and breathe into it? With the next inhale, let's start to bring the body back up and just step that back foot up to meet the left. Close the eyes and scan that left side, scan the right. Feel a little difference, maybe not. Okay, let's open the eyes and sweep the arms overhead on a big breath in. Exhale, take the forward fold. Take that half lift. Coming up and exhale, come on down. Press the floor away as we inhale, rising up. As we exhale, hands to hips. This time it's the left foot that steps back. Same thing here, either up on the ball of the foot, right knee is bent, right hip back, left hip forward, or you can drop the heel and find a warrior one pose. As we inhale, we sweep the arms up. And as we exhale, just bend the elbows out to the side, spread the fingers, right? Lengthen the heart, presses up. And then inhale, straighten that front leg as we reach. Exhale, bend the knee, bend the elbows. Beautiful. And two more times like that. Right, flowing like that river. And then inhale, rising up. We're going to take that back foot in a little bit closer. So both legs are straight. Bring the palms to the right thigh. Take a breath in as we exhale. Let's find that flat back. Folding forward, nice and slow. Right, and notice the sensation down the back of that right leg. Maybe it's enough. If you're looking for a little bit more on the next exhale, maybe fingertips to the block. Maybe drop the head and releasing back down. Breathing into the stretch. And on the next inhale, we rise back up and just step that back foot to meet the right and bring the hands to the heart. I was going to bring you guys into a standing split, but I figured we'll do that a little bit later when we're more warmed up. And your arms up. They're fun. Exhale, forward fold. Take that half lift. Come on up. And exhale back down. Sweep the arms as we rise. Hands to hips. This time we're taking a big step with the right foot. We're going to bend into the left knee. And we're going to take the arms out from the shoulders. So the hips are facing that right side of the room, but we're gazing over the left fingertips. Beautiful warrior two pose. Flipping the palms towards the sky as we inhale, straighten that front leg and just let the arms, as we exhale, flow back down to warrior two. Just one more time like that. Coming back down and then turn that left palm towards the sky and inhale the left fingers up towards the sky, peaceful warrior. As we exhale, straighten that front leg and just reach the left fingers up, right fingers down for reverse triangle. Take a big breath here. And on the exhalation, arms float down, T position, reach through the left fingertips. When you can't reach anymore, just pivot the arms. Right hand reaches up, left hand down, as long as it's not the knee. So the thigh, calf, shin, ankle block. And we find our Trikonasana, triangle pose. Big breath in. And then use that right hand to bring us all the way back up. Rebend that front knee and find warrior two. Take the left forearm down to the thigh. And without moving the hips, just swing that back arm up and over into extended side angle. And then take the hands all the way down to the mat. Bend the knees. First come to the knees, separate them nice and wide. And as we exhale, hips towards the heels, find a child's pose. So the arms can extend. You can make two little fists and just drop the forehead onto the fists. Breathing into our child's pose. Let's reconnect with the breath. The sensations in the body. And that intention, right? Just to allow ourselves to flow. On the next exhale, rising back up. We'll take a little cat and cow here. Just drop the belly, lift the gaze. As you exhale, press the floor away, chin to chest, round the spine. And one more time like that, dropping the belly, looking up. And exhale, reversing into cat. And then drop the belly into cow, take a breath and tuck the toes as we exhale, lift the hips, find downward facing dog. From here, walking the feet back up to the top of the mat, bending the knees as we sweep the arms, rising all up. Exhale, hands to hips. This time it's the left foot that takes that big step back, bending the right knee. Sweep the arms out so the hips are facing that left side, but we're gazing over the right fingertips. Beautiful. As we inhale, straighten that front leg, hands meet in prayer. As we exhale, float back down, warrior two. And one more time like that, inhale, rising up. And exhale, floating down. And then flip that right palm towards the sky as we inhale, right fingers reach up, left fingers down. A peaceful warrior pose, beautiful. Take a breath here. And then straighten that front leg and reach the right fingers towards the sky. The left fingers go down the back leg for reverse triangle. Big breath in, and as we exhale, pivot the arms, reach through the right hand. And when we can't reach anymore, let those right fingers come down, left fingers up, and find Trikonasana. Beautiful. Relax the shoulders, relax the face. Take another breath here. And then as if that left hand could grab an invisible hook and pull you back up, rebending that front knee, finding Warrior Two just for a breath. And then the right forearm to the right thigh, and the left arm comes up and over, extended side angle. Beautiful. Let's inhale and come back up and step that back foot up to meet the front. Give a fake. Okay, maybe a drink if you have some water. Whew. More windows? I went to open those, but there's nothing there. Here we go. Okay, there we go. Ooh, let me know if it gets too cold. Okay. I don't know about that. Huh? Yeah. Okay. So, turning the toes out, taking the feet as wide as the mat, maybe even coming off the mat, bring the palms to the thighs and take a little squat, coming into our goddess pose. And so we're not supposed to call this goddess anymore. We're supposed to call it horse stance. Because everybody, yeah, right? Sorry, I still call it goddess. Lift the toes so that the weight shifts into the heels, spread them, and then gently place them back down. And then as we inhale, sweep the arms up, let the hands meet in prayer. And as we exhale, just let the hands find the heart. And then reverse inhale and let the legs straighten coming up. Beautiful. And exhale, we bend the knees. And let the hands come down to the heart. We'll do that a couple of times. It's so like a waterfall. Beautiful, cascading up. And the next time we bend the knees, pause here. And I want you guys to just find some spontaneous movement with the breath in and out of your goddess. You don't have to follow me. You can. Letting the arms be like gentle reeds in the wind, or maybe seaweed. Beautiful. There you go. And then I promise I'll get us out of a squat in a minute. Take one more big breath coming all the way up. And as we exhale, just let those arms float down. Bring one hand to the belly, one hand to the heart. And breathe and connect. Step the feet in a little bit more. And let's take empty coat sleeves. Just twisting that out. Back to center for a little bit of breath of joy. So little bend to the knees. So we're going to be very buoyant here, right? Bending and coming up. So breath of joy is that three-part inhale, arms come in front, to the side, overhead. And when we exhale, we just bend the knees and just let everything go. And don't worry if you've got it right or wrong, just three inhales and one big exhale. Let's begin. Inhale, arms in front, to the side, overhead. Beautiful. Yes. Up, out, all the way up. In front, side, up. Yes. So find your rhythm. Beautiful. So every breath, we're bringing prana, new life, new beginnings. Every exhale, releasing whatever it is that doesn't serve you. Let's take three more. Let's get loud for the next two. Ha! Last one. Ha! And then slowly. Yeah! Come on back up, and just for a moment, close the eyes and notice the vibration that's still, that movement that's going through the body, right? We stopped, but there's still movement. That's our prana moving. Okay, so let's start to shift our weight from one foot to the other. We're going to be very playful here with that balancing tonight. Take a breath, come on up. And as you exhale, bring the hands to the hips and just step the right foot back. So your choice from here, taking the block or maybe even two, bringing the block down, we come up on those back toes and just lift the leg and come into a supported warrior three pose. Right, letting the head extend out, those toes pointing back, nothing crazy, right? Just breathing here in our balance. If anyone wants to play a little bit, having a block in the left hand with that wrist right under the shoulder, bringing the hand to the right hip and turning the hip to the right side. So we come into our balancing half moon. Being careful with this. I'll be someone's wall if they need a wall. You got it, Miss Joyce. Come on. I gotcha. I'll be your wall. Beautiful. Beautiful. And then if you want, you could even extend that arm up. Ah, gorgeous. Okay. And then coming out nice and slow. That was beautiful. See, I can't do that on Zoom. Oh, Enid, look at you. I'm sorry. I called your name. That's what happens. I'm so sorry. I should know that. See? Let's take that to the other side. Inhale, bring the arms up. See, you didn't know you could do that. Exhale, hands to hips. This time the left foot steps back. And then you just come up on those left toes and bring the right hand to the block and lift that back leg up and stay here if you're not comfortable turning into, whoops, that balancing half moon. And if anybody wants a little help, wants me to be there, beautiful Maria, I know you can do this. Yeah. Oh my. There you go. You can lean into me. See? Beautiful. Just breathing wherever you are, beautiful Maria, both my Marias. And then whenever you're ready, lowering back down. She's not ready. That was beautiful, Sha. Yeah, one side is always. And bringing the hands to the heart, taking a breath and just acknowledging your willingness to play, right? To play, to flow, have a little fun with it. And take the feet a little bit closer together, maybe even touching toes and heels, and inhale, sweep the arms overhead. Let the right hand grab the left wrist and take the hips all the way out to the left as we reach to the right, coming into Ardha Chandrasana, our half moon pose, shoulders released down, press the feet into the floor. As we inhale, we lengthen. As we exhale, where can you let go? Okay, where can you release? Let's press into the feet, coming back up, switch that grip. Left hand takes the right wrist, brings the arm all the way up and over. The hips press all the way to the right, and we reach to the left. Big breath in. As we exhale, shoulders release. We relax the face. And then inhale to come back up. And release those arms back down. Separate the feet a little bit wider. Bring hands to the heart. And we're going to bend the knees, turning the toes out. So moving into either just a little squat, right? The palms can come to the thighs. Or if anybody wants to come all the way down and play with malasana or the yogi squat. Just meeting yourself exactly where you are, right? And no judgment here. We're making our way back down to the mat. As we exhale, bringing the hands down and letting the knees come back down and just wagging the hips a little bit from side to side. Oh my goodness, where's the time going? Let's find our tabletop, right? Spread the fingers nice and wide. Press the floor away. And then take the right toes and bring them back and look up. As you exhale, hug the knee to the chest, rounding the spine. As we inhale, lengthen and look up. And do that two more times, coming in and out of our tiger pose. And the next time the right leg extends, you can stay here just pointing the toes or walk the left fingers to the top of the mat, press into the left foot, and maybe float the left arm up for our balancing cat, sunbird. This one has a lot of different names. And relax the shoulders, relax the face. And if that hand is up, the left hand finds the mat, we're going to bend that right knee and bring it all the way over to the right side of the mat and start walking the left toes back. And I invite you to take a block under that right hip if you'd like a little support in your pigeon tonight, staying up high, or even taking a seated pigeon. Okay, nobody's in a seated pigeon. Start out nice, long spine, proud pigeon. And then as we exhale, just begin walking the arms out, maybe coming to the forearms, maybe stacking one hand on top of the other. Find some support for the forehead. Just releasing the head down to the mat. You can stack the fists or even take that block and breathe deep here. So it takes the body a while to realize it's safe. So bring all your attention into the right hip with every exhalation. Never any pain or sharp sensation, especially in the joints. So be careful with that knee. And with every breath, can you release a little bit more into that stretch? Take three more breaths here. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Every breath, just letting it go. And then start to walk the palms back towards the body, and on an exhale, press the body up. Bend that left knee. And just circle the toes, releasing the ankle a bit. You can stay with that or press into the right palm and bring the left hand back. Maybe find the foot for a deeper stretch. Maybe not. Some days I find it on one side and not the other. And then let the hand come down and just take that right hip down to the mat and swing that left leg around. So we can find out Janu Shirsasan, right foot up against the left thigh. I think that's such a cool little move. I don't know. I was all excited when, thank you. I found that one. I was like, oh, look how good that flows. Left toes up. You can use a strap here if you'd like, or just let the hand travel down to wherever it's comfortable. So we're going to start just by turning the body. So we're looking at those left toes, letting the left hand come up to the hip. The right hand is pressing into the right knee. So we're opening up to the side. And as we exhale, take that to the other side. Left fingers turn down and we turn and we look towards the right. Do that again. Inhale, coming up. And exhale. Almost like we're giving ourselves a little massage. One more time. Inhale, looking over towards that left side. And this time sliding the left fingers all the way down, keeping the right hip down to the mat. And as we inhale, take those right fingers up and over, coming into a beautiful side bend. And you can take that right hand and support the back of the head if that feels better. You can reach for the toes, just breathing here. And notice how much more space there might be on that right side from when we first started. And then use the next breath to bring the arms up towards the sky, and we'll take a counter stretch. Right palm finds the mat, and we just come up and reach those left fingers all the way back. Taking the hips down and coming back into tabletop. So So coming towards the end, guys, extending the left toes back, finding the length, pressing the floor away, looking up in our tiger pose. As we exhale, knee comes into the chest. And then inhale, extend and look up. So it's almost like a cow with the belly dropping. And then as we exhale, it's like a cat, but the knees coming in. And two more times like that. And the next time that knee comes in, we're gonna drop it to the left side of the mat and start to walk the right toes back. And just wiggling the hips a little side to side and working your way into your pigeon pose. So the other day I was in a class and they gave a really cool cue. They said, squeeze the knees towards each other and it kind of squares the hips. And I've been practicing forever, teaching for 12 years. I never heard that. So I don't know if that helps anyone, like the knees kind of move towards each other. So maybe not, but it works for me. Start nice, tall, long spine, proud pigeon. And as we exhale, start to work your way down. And then find a place where the forehead can rest on either blocks, stacked hands or fists. Breathing here. If it's okay with you guys, we'll go a little past 8 because I want to have a really good juicy shavasana after this. Take some deep breaths in, and as you exhale, maybe even let the mouth open and sigh it out. And just letting that breath move like that beautiful Mother Ganges, right? If it comes to any obstacles, flowing around and over. On the next exhalation, start to walk the palms back, press the body up and bend the right knee, circling the toes, a little release for the ankles. And just stay here or press into that left palm and reach that right hand back. Maybe find the foot, maybe not. If you do, give it a little press towards the butt. It's a nice quad stretch. And then releasing that, just let that left hip come down and swing that right leg all the way around. Left foot to the inside of the right thigh. Janya Shirsasana, other side. Start to take the right fingers down the leg as the left hand curls up to the left hip, turning and looking to the left. As we exhale, take it the other way and twist towards the right. And two more times like that. Gentle little massage for the legs and the thighs. I think they carried you through class tonight. Next time that right hand travels down the leg, pause here and then sweep the left arm up and over into the side bend. Lengthening on the inhale, and as you exhale, can you just surrender? In the Kripalu tradition, there's something that we call brithwa. Let's inhale, coming up, both arms reach up, and the left hand comes behind us as we push hip, reach that arm behind. Letting the hips come down and seeing if there's any of the movement the body would like before coming down on the mat into relaxation. I'm going to close these a bit for that because the body will cool down. And I want everyone to be really relaxed and lower the lights. So BRIFWA is an acronym that we use for breathe, right? Breathe into sensation. Relax what you can. Oh, that's pretty. Feel, right? Feel it all. Don't push anything away. We have to let all of those emotions run through us. We need to feel them. Then watch. Watch your reactions. Emotions. And then allow what is. So releasing now, releasing the practice, releasing the effort, and just allowing the body to be. Let's go back to that beautiful river, as if you're lying on a raft, floating. With every inhalation, the body expands. With every exhalation, it releases a little bit deeper. Start to relax the shoulder blades, the back of the head, the hips and the seat muscles. I'm gonna come around with a little bit of lavender oil if you would like. Just turn your palm up and we'll put a drop on your hand so you can rub. Did you get it? Oh, sorry, I can't see, so you might get a lot. Didn't think this one out too well. Okay, so relaxing shoulders, shoulder blades, upper arms, elbows. Forearms, wrists, and all 10 fingers. Relax the throat, the back, and the sides of the neck. The space around the heart and the upper back. The middle back and the waist. The lower back and the belly. Relax the seat muscles, the hips and the pelvis. Relax the thighs and the knees and the calves and the shins, the ankles and the feet and all 10 toes. And just for a few moments, absolutely nothing to do except breathe. Any thoughts that come up, we acknowledge, and then we send them on the way. With every exhalation, the body becomes more relaxed. And we let go. I would love to live like a river, surprised by the unfolding of its own being. I would love to live like a river, surprised by the unfolding of its own being. Can we practice being okay without knowing what's going to happen next? Let go of the ways you thought life would unfold, the holding of plans or dreams or expectations. Let it all go and save your strength to swim with the tide. The choice to fight what is here before you now will only result in struggle, fear, and desperate attempts to flee from the very energy you long for. Let it all go and flow with the grace that washes through your days. Let go and the wave's crest will carry you to unknown shores beyond your wildest dreams or destinations. Let it all go and find the peace of rest and certain transformation. I am the light of my soul. I am beautiful. I am bountiful. I am bliss. And adding whatever else you would like to add, what message do you have for your heart? And then gently start to deepen the breath. Bring some movement back, maybe wiggling fingers and toes or rocking the head side to side. If it feels good, a stretch, like we're just waking up. And then gently rolling over to one side and finding a fetal position as we transition back and taking your time and just noticing how the body is feeling, how the breath is moving, the thoughts and the mind, and if something maybe shifted from an hour ago. So maybe there's a little more space. Maybe there's a little more peace, whatever it is, thanking yourself for taking the time and coming to your mat to explore and be curious, sharing your beautiful energy with everyone here in this room. And then when you're ready, gently pressing to any comfortable seat, joining the hands at the heart and bowing to that beautiful divine light that exists in all of us. And when we are here in this space together, we are one. Namaste. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much, guys. Yay.
A live group, yes. I'm gonna hit the lights. I also.